Ashley Cravat, wearing foodie, and our favourite judge from MasterChef joining us this morning from Melbourne. It is Matt Preston, everyone.
Morning.
A very good morning to you, Matt Preston. Oh, gee, you're looking handsome in cream, aren't you?
Resplendent.
You look like a banana paddle pop.
I'm calling it... I think banana paddle pop or Cornish dairy ice cream. Very high in fat, whatever it is.
What are you doing this morning for us?
Well, look, I'm down here by the banks of the Yarra outside the Crown Entertainment Centre, and I'm at the Pimm's Garden Bar, and I'm going to make a very simple kind of summery drink that goes perfect with tennis in my book, which is a Pimm's Cup. It's a drink that's absolutely wedded to Wimbledon in the UK, and it's a really light drink. So I'm going to knock that up. Then the next thing I'm going to show you, Pimm's has to have strawberries in it if you want it to make it that lovely kind of fragrant, feminine flavoured drink. Yes, so I'm going to show you a couple of ways of hulling strawberries.
Oh.
A little insider tip. But, okay. the Pimm's Cup is one of those, I think there's a lot of myth about cocktail making that it's tricky. They're complex, and actually I don't think cocktails are any harder, or welcome drinks like this are any harder to make than really opening a bottle of your favorite white wine. So, but what I always do, always use a measuring jug for your spirits. You know exactly how much you're putting in the jug. I'm using 300 mils of Pimm's. Well, that's about it there. It's a little like under a half, but you're making a big jug, so it's going to go a long way. 300 mils, put it on a flat surface so you can actually see the level. Pour in your Pimm's. Yeah. And then it's really making the Pimm's. Here, this is the really tricky bit. Open a bottle of lemonade. Oh. Pour it in.
What's everybody else having, Matt?
My fists are pretty big, so this does look kind of in pro for me. Obviously, with George, we'd give him. He's got small hands. We'll give him a nice little glass. So some dry ginger ale. In England, they drink Pimm's with lemonade, which I think makes it a bit too sweet. But with dry ginger ale, you get a little bit of that spiciness, which is delicious. 300 mils of dry ginger ale, and then garnish. Cucumber loves Pimm's.
Yes.
Pimm's originally was made to serve with oysters. So we're going to put some cucumber in there. A little bit of orange. I mean, obviously now Pimm's, I think, is that because of Wimbledon is associated with strawberries and cream, which is why down here at the Pimm's Garden Bar, they're going to give you, with every jug of Pimm's you buy, a serve of strawberries and cream. How delicious is that?
Do you come with the Pimm's,
some
Matt?
Fresh
Pimm's,
Matt? for you, of course. Very important when you're using mint. When you're using mint, this is an old bartender, you have to spank your mint. I don't know why. I think it's to release the aromas. You give your mint
naughty.
A good spank, and suddenly it smells super fragrant. In goes the mint, and now strawberries. Now, we could use a knife. Bit dangerous that, because obviously I'm not like Gary, I'm not technically skilled. You could use one of these things, which strangely reminds me of George as well. This is a strawberry huller. And all you do is you pull it open like that, you pop it in, you close it down, and out comes your whole strawberry.
How cute is
that? The strawberry goes in. Or if you're not a techno boy, this is my favourite one at the moment. We take a straw. Now, you want a straw that's not too bendy, so this one's got a bit more resistance. You put your straw in at this end of the strawberry. Now, that's why they're called strawberries. And you push through, and hopefully, if you get this right... have lots of strawberries on hand.
Can I ask, though, what is wrong with the centre of a strawberry?
Yeah, you don't want the green.
I think getting rid of
the green off.
Well, the leaves are a bit. You don't want to eat the leaves; they're not very nice. And then at that point, you go back to using the knife, because that straw didn't work there.
You
keep asking me questions. You keep asking me questions, and I'm just going to keep doing this because I am a stubborn person. I'm now going to try and change to the original straw, the one I rejected.
Let me ask you,
MasterChef,
can you tell us something about the upcoming season of MasterChef?
Well, I can let you in on the secret that we've got a wonderful chef called Yotam Ottolenghi, called Ottolenghi in London. He's coming out. He's amazing. What's great about Yotam is he's a... there's the middle strawberry out there. He is originally a philosophy student, and also a journalist. So he's like our contestants. He's come from an area where he wanted to bake. He started baking, and then he opened up Ottolinghi, a range of cafes. He's got Nopi, the restaurant. He's got four best-selling cookbooks. He's a beautiful, humble man, and he's going to be with us for a whole week. So that's very exciting for me, George and Gary, and I think for the contestants as well.
Oh, it's such a brilliant, brilliant show. We can't wait for it to be back on our screen. Show us that hulled strawberry. You've got to give us proof of life because we missed it before. No.
Oh, story checks out.
Matt Preston in Melbourne, thank you so much for joining us. Can't wait to see you and the fellas back on telly.